Autoclave speed were remained as the penultimate race of the Cobalt Truck Series season, and the stakes remained just as high. One race until we end it at Kansas. On the pole for the ninth event is the 3 of Paul Jackson. 2 is outside is the 97 of Stephen Colon. 3rd is Jarakowski. 4th is Chris Reynolds. Running out of the top 5 is Dylan Verminion. Rest of the qualifying order on the left side of the screen. Points leader William Brock ahead by 159 over Mitchell Collins. Starts 32nd. He'll have to claw his way back up through the field for a good result. Collins himself, however, doesn't really start that much better. He starts 20th, but Auto Club is just about as crazy as a super speedway, if not crazier. They come to the line. Green flag is out. We're racing at Auto Club. Paul Jackson leads them through the first two turns, but that won't be the case for basically anywhere else until he gets back up front. You're going to see 3 wide, you're going to see 4 wide, you're going to possibly see 5 wide, and a big shuffle for the lead, and not without a little bit of danger of crashing into the outside wall in turn number 1. So to the line, to lead lap number 1, Rutkowski and Paul Jackson battle. It'll be Rutkowski getting the edge. And a 46 of Dan Harrison making his way down low. Already got 4 wide. Almost 5 wide back there. I believe that would be 5 wide. So already very, very close together and packed in this race. Just 2 laps in. Dan Harrison leads them off of turn number 4, but that will not stay the same for long. 4 wide down on the bottom for Foster Henderson, Felix Jansen, and I want to say that is the 18, yes it is, the 18 of Samet Oskin. The pack basically 4 by 4 throughout the field. As Dan Harrison moves up the high a bit. And this isn't going to end well back there. Into the wall goes Nelson Reeves. Reeves takes a spin, but really nothing else to note. As Dan Harrison leads them back to the caution flag. They touch coming back. But they refrain from wrecking, so good job there. So Reeves into the outside wall in a place that we usually don't see wrecks. But they were how wide here? They were 5 wide right in front of the Chevrolet of Nelson Reeves. But it actually happened around him. So Trey Smith, he's one of our title contenders. So that'll be a big hit to his chances. Albeit he's 252 points back, probably out of it, but he's fourth nonetheless. So basically a mathematical underdog, very much of an underdog at this point. But you see they just get, I want to say that would be 5 wide. 2 goes around, so does the 6. Rutkowski's going to have damage from that. Your pole sitter might have gotten a piece. But in the end, no one's going to be out from this race yet. There it is one more time. Reeves actually got up on 2 wheels for a second there, but came back down and he took a spin. Really nothing much else to note, but they got a bit close and personal. Coming into turn number 1, which is where we do usually see the wrecks. But luckily they got that slowed down and sorted out. So leading them back to the line, it was the 46 of Dan Harrison. Behind him was Michael Triplett. 3rd is 2nd in points, Mitchell Collins. He's going to have a good run. while the 21 runs in the back. If he wants to have a shot at winning this championship going into Kansas. Austin Bateman rides in 4th and Carter Joey 5th. That'll be your top 5 heading to the restart. As the one to go has just been called, we're back green here. So triplet down low, they battle side by side down the back stretch. Collins already put to the outside by Bateman. So he'll have to work his way back up front once again. That's just how it works at Auto Club. You could get pushed back to the outside and have to do everything all over again. Three wide for the lead, Carter Joey. And the 98. Getting a huge push from Stapleton, and Stapleton right here is going to get the lead. DJ Reed moved up 6 points, or 6 positions in points, after the last race where he might have just put himself back in this. Once again, he'll probably be a huge underdog in a long shot like the 6 of Trey Smith is, but he could possibly be in this if he wins this race. And, oh, well, not anymore. He's going around hard into the wall for Jake Galloway, into the fence, and comes back down on all four wheels. The caution is out. A savage wreck for the 24 of Jake Galloway. And that will possibly be it for Mr. Collins if he has gotten in this. Does his truck have that much damage? White possibly could have escaped this melee. But the 52 for sure. I'm pretty sure he went from the bottom of the racetrack to the top. Yes, there he is on pit road, so he is done. So possibly a moment for the commentator curse. It looks like Felix Jansen has led them back to the line, but obviously a very serious accident, a very spectacular one involving Jake Galloway. So here they were, 4 wide, right up against the wall, and that's going to get Carter Joey down into the 52. He goes down the racetrack, gets Jake Galloway, who shifts back up into the wall. He shoots back out and goes flying into the catch fence. Reed actually also goes up on his side in this whole ordeal, and 24 turning gyrations up on his nose, pirouetting, gets hit by the 3 of Paul Jackson and goes flipping once again until he lands back on all four wheels. So hopefully the driver of the 24 GMS Chevrolet, Jake Galloway, is okay. But, my goodness, what a wreck. As we take a look at it again. I think we all knew when the 24 went from the top of the racetrack to the top, the bottom of the racetrack to the top, that it was going to be bad. And it clearly was. Luckily, he didn't catch the wall and fling into the catch fence like we saw Nathan Orman did, like at Homestead. But this is obviously just as bad. As look at that truck fly into the air, and then the oncoming Paul Jackson puts some flipping, and he lands back on all four wheels. Another view. This one's just going to capture how serious this accident is. Look at that truck fly. Oh, and then he gets hit by the 3, so we'll go one more angle and get back to the green flag. Actually, we'll do this in slow motion first. We'll get an onboard. But look at that. The car, it might have caught the wall. I'm not quite sure. That possibly could be why it ejected that abruptly and went flying after contact with the 52. And you see the 3, he's trying to avoid it, but he can't get his truck turned just in time, and he strikes Jake Galloway's truck. So I think he could be the best person to go on board with. As we'll see here what we can get. But this is definitely not something, thanks notification, not something you want to see out your windshield. Watch this. So Felix Jansen led them back to the caution flag. He'll lead them to the green. As, the cleanup has been completed. And we'll get back to the action quite shortly. There's the one to go. It'll be Jansen, Miles, Stapleton, Thompson, and Stephen Colon. Rest of the order. DJ Reed is at his race. Might have definitely been an episode of the commentator's curse. I'm not sure. Ian Bongong, Paul Jackson, and Jake Galloway join him as out. So we go back green. Probably the only ones with a shot at this championship. Officially going to Kansas now will be Mitchell Collins and William Brock. Trey Smith was involved in that first accident. He's probably too far back anyways to make something happen. Even if the 41 and 21 both wreck. Speaking of the 21, he's on the inside back there, so he could be looking for a good result this evening. But up front, the 13 and the 20 sit side by side, 4 wide for third. In the meantime, and look at the 33. He might be trying to split the middle here. He makes it 4 wide for the lead for a moment. Down on the very bottom, it's Foster Henderson trying to get to the inside. And Henderson will clear for the... No, he won't. He goes to the middle. Cara Bell forces him up there. As we're already back to this intense racing. You see them from the helicopter. They go around again. Stephen Colon into the wall. And it appears that Collins has sustained some sort of damage. So he could have been in that accident a bit more than we thought. But coming to the line, William Brock and Landon Smith Jr. will battle it out. Will Smith Jr. get the push from Stover? He will, and he will lead this lap, and he will lead the field to a late race restart. So it was the 97 of Stephen Colon spinning around on turn number one just after the restart. And hopefully we can get a green flag finish to this race. But yeah, it looks like the 13 and I want to say that's the 33. Yes, it is. Got a bit too squeezed up into the wall and they went around, so basically that is the only thing we saw happen under this caution. Nothing too major like we saw last time. But these are the types of wrecks you usually see at Auto Club. And that big one last race, quite the scare. And obviously the Jake Galloway accident just a few laps ago. So the 22 has just bested William Brock, who is looking to lock this championship up early. As it'll be, once again, a late race restart with Smith Jr., William Brock, Brad Stover, Luke Rainey, and Joshua Harrison. What will the teammates for the 41 do to prevent his title rival winning this race and possibly the championship? In 97, a Stephen Cullen has retired of this race. That's shocking considering that nothing really happened to him. Except a bit of a scrape to the wall, but that's basically it. So they come to the start-finish line under caution, coming to the green for the last time. We will restart with four to go. Green flag is back out at Auto Club. There he is, William Brock to the inside looking for the lead in turn two. But now here it is, Stover going to the inside of him. Will he have a big enough push from Luke Rainey, however? No, Rainey is going to make his own move towards the front. But Stover is still going to get the run. And you see Luke Rainey, he's constantly peeking here. But that's still giving the 88 some draft. At the line, it was the 21 by just a little bit. So can William Brock hang on this outside lane? They beat and they bang in the back. Here comes the 8 of Bronson Minnick looking for his first win this season. 46 as well, going to the inside. And meanwhile, you've got Christian Vargas in the 10 looking for his third. They get very close to the wall, but they don't squeeze up into it to cause a caution. There's the 2 and Nelson Reese coming out of pit road. He keeps off of the pack. That is 5 wide back there. Will they keep it straight? It looks like everyone will come out clean. And it is Dan Harrison with the lead. Coming to the white flag. They all stay straight on the straightaway. 4 wide for second. White flag is out. 1 more lap to go at Auto Club. That's 5 wide back there in the back. Owen Miles to the inside. They are side by side while the pack sits 4 wide back there. Can Young Motorsports teammate Nathan Stapleton battle Owen Miles? He will. It'll be a finish between the 02 and 20 coming to line. Believe Owen Miles got it. He did. So Owen Miles, your winner at Auto Club. Is set for Kansas, and clearly the one taking the spotlight is William Brock. He will have a quite the large point lead over Mitchell Collins. As Collins, he just had something happen during that caution, put him behind the 8 ball. He sits 27th I believe William Brock might have locked up this championship early. So it's a Young's Motorsport 1-2, as both the 02 and 20 gave their all, Owen Miles and Nathan Stapleton, first and second at Auto Club. Dan Harrison in third, his teammate Carter Friesen makes it fourth, and another KBM driver, Chris Reynolds, fifth. Felix Jansen, sixth, seventh is another KBM driver, Simon Oskin, so I believe that puts all four other trucks in the top 10. So a good job by Kyle Busch Motorsports tonight. Michael Triplett in 8th, Joshua Harrison 9th, and Zachary Davis rounds out the top 10. Here's the rest of the finishing results. We had 28 trucks on the lead lap. Nelson Reeves was the only one to be a lap down. Everyone else under him was out of the race. Just to check, I got this up. Let's go to victory lane with the 0-2 of Owen Miles. He comes out victorious at Auto Club. Thank you for watching the GoBot Truck Series. We'll see you next time.